In this video, I will show you how to modify a switch mode power supply with DC 12 volt output to 14.5 volt for charging any car battery. Step by step. This is an AC 220 volt to DC 12 volt switch mode power supply, and its output terminals have been connected to a multimeter's DC position to measure the output voltage. Switched the power on. The output was 12.63 volt. Indicated by the multimeter. Connected a car battery to the power supply's output terminals. Charging voltage was 12.61 volt. And almost the same as battery's own voltage. Obviously, the DC voltage level at 12.61 volt from the power supply's output was not good at all for charging the battery. But adjuster here has been reached at the high end. So the power supply needs to be modified in order to be able to charge the car's battery. Now unscrewing secured screws to disassemble the case to get the circuit board inside. Here we go. The whole circuit board is here. AC 220 volt is from here, through EMI filter, then a bridge rectifier. DC 311 volt reached at capacitors here. Two switching transistors, controlled by IC chip here. After high frequency and isolated transformer, a Schottky diode for rectifier. Then filter from larger value of capacitors. Finally, the DC output is there. IC chip as a controller is. KA7500. The one of those resistors can be modified for increasing level of the DC output. Let's find it out. This is the voltage divided circuit, which consists of four resistors, their values from that circuit board. An adjustable 1K ohms resistor is at the bottom. The arrow is connected to IC KS7500. A 2.7K ohms resistor is the one on the left for those four resistors on the circuit board, which will be modified. Also, three capacitors here need to be replaced. Because of their low voltage rate of 16 volt, plus a load resistor, there is better off to be replaced due to its low wattage dissipation. Let me repeat again. To replace a load resistor, three capacitors, and modify a voltage divided resistor. Here is a setup of testing run for a chosen resistor, which is the one with 20K ohms connected to a 2.7K ohms resistor on the circuit board in parallel. Switched the power on. Let me have them connected properly. The voltage increased to 14.16 volt. You see, 14.16 volt and steady. It worked. An actual resistor chosen. 17K ohms and soldered here. These capacitors need to be taken out. This is a capacitor with 16 volt and 2200 μF, three of these combined. 16 volt and 6600 μF capacity. By using a capacitor with 35 volt and 6800 μF capacity as a replacement. Now is taking a load resistor out. This original load resistor is 465 ohms with 1 watt dissipation. A replacement resistor is 475 ohms and 2 watt. There are plenty of rooms here to fill in the replacement of the capacitor and resistor. Soldering them on their places on the circuit board. Then assembling the case. And secured. The same battery is showed previously here. And the modified power supply has been on. Ready for charging testing run. Connected the battery from the power supply and multimeter's probes to the battery terminals. (14.16 volt) indicated by the meter. That was very good charging voltage level, and the power supply has been modified successfully. Adjusting the output voltage level from high at 14.52 volt. To low at 11.25 volt. That is the range of the DC output voltage for this modified power supply. One more thing, according to a sticker here, output 12 volt and 20 amperes. That means 12 volt times 20 amperes equals 240 watt, which is the power supply's capacity. As we know, the high level output voltage is 14.5 volt times what's amperes equals 240 watt. So it is. I maximum equals 240 over 14.5 equals 16.55 amperes. In other words, this modified power supply has the output capacity of 240 watt. At high voltage of 14.5 volt, its maximum output current is 16.55 amperes. In order to prevent from supplying too much current, an overload protection switch to be used, likes the one here. The switch will be connected between the output positive terminal and load. Incidentally speaking, the switch's rating is 15 amperes. Then fixed it into the hole on the DIY bracket, which also installed a LED there. As whole, it looks like this. Of course, the whole thing will be fixed on a piece of wood as their base. Please pay attention. The switch is in front of the LED in their circuit. Here we go, all done. A draft inserted is the diagram for overload protection and a LED circuit. The power supply box and DIY bracket have been secured on the board. AC 220 volt terminals covered with tape. The battery's negative, alligator, and positive, alligator. When the power is on, both LED here and indicator inside there will be on. Switched the power on, we can see, they are all on. Switched the power off now. Here is the load testing has been set up, with two of the car's headlights connected to the output. Total power consumption is 200 watt, so their combined current will be more than 16 amperes. The switch should activate after a little while, when the power is on. Switched the power on. The LED indicator is on. It worked. And the button on the switch popped up now. Also, the LED indicator was off. After waiting a few seconds, push the button on the switch down, then everything is all right. Now you've known how to modify 12-volt switch mode power supply. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe if you have enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.